मैप्स एंड ग्राफ ऑफ लेसन नंबर 4 क्लाइमेट. सो लेट्स बिगिन विद दैट.
एसएमएस करना.
Okay, now the first over here, what is the question? The first question what they asked, just look over there. Whenever you're marking the outline, the first step of the marking of the outline is the first. For example, here the first question is southwest monsoon wind or the wind bringing rainfall to most part of India. So your first question is southwest monsoon wind. And where it is in the south direction. Just look at this, how I outline the southwest monsoon wind. After marking the outline, write here one, and then write here question, southwest monsoon wind. Whenever you're preparing or whenever you're marking the outline, you should go with all this thing. First of all, show the proper label like this. When I'm talking about the wind, so you should always show the arrow. Okay. The first question, what is the first question? The first question is southwest monsoon wind. So here you mark like this, southwest. Okay, sorry, it's my fault. Okay. So now this is a southwest monsoon wind. Okay. And here my mark first. Afterward, marking the first, what you will do, always draw an index properly. Always draw a proper index. This is an index. And it carries 2 marks, students. If you forget to draw an index, then you lose the 2 marks. So after making an index, first what you will go, first what is your question? Southwest monsoon wind. So mark properly the wind arrow and then write the question in that index. Then now second one. What is the second one? The second one is, yes, exactly. Northeast monsoon wind. Now second is northeast monsoon wind. So obviously when we are talking about the northeast monsoon wind, it is here. Okay. Mark it properly, northeast monsoon wind, and then write in the index like this arrow, and then write in the index northeast monsoon wind. Now third one, Kargil. Okay, Kargil is a place which is located in which direction, student? I want to answer from you. In which direction you can see Kargil? Okay, this is the Kargil. Here you write 3 and then mark it Kargil in the north direction. Afterward, the next question is Cherrapunji and Mousiram. Now, where the Cherrapunji is located, it is in the east, west, north or south? In which direction? Yes, exactly. Okay, some are saying east, some are saying south, some are saying east. Okay. Eastern south or southeastern? Northeastern direction. So here we mark it as Cherrapunji and Mousiram. So mark each and everything properly, student, in proper direction. If it is located in a northeast direction, your labeling should be in the proper direction only. So now the first question. Okay, who will read the first question, student? Just raise your hand. Saying the first question is only that much. That wind bringing rainfall in Brazil from 2 trade winds, that is northeast and southeast trade wind. So you will show here northeast trade wind and the second is southeast trade wind. So this is the first one. Okay. Afterward, the next question, that is drought quadrilateral. Sometimes they are asking only. So take a screenshot of this through graph. Okay. So do you have a test also? okay, to whom they didn't. Okay, so let's move. You can see this. So I ask you some question. In which month, okay, in which month is the highest temperature found in all the four cities? So there are the four cities we can see. There are the four cities. What are the name of the four cities which you can see in the screen? Okay, tell me the name of the cities. Just write in this chat box. Okay, so in Manaus, in which month the temperature is higher? Okay, March. Okay, all are saying March. August to October. Okay, fine. Let me see how many answers. So, black is for maximum temperature and blue is for minimum temperature. So now tell me which month, in which month it is higher temperature. Okay. In Belem, in which month the higher temperature is there? Belem. Yes, exactly. June to December. Okay. Now we move to the next. 4 to Allegri. Now, what about 4 to Allegri? Okay. Sama saying January to February. Yes, exactly. January and February. Now we move to the next, Rio de Janeiro. So in which month Rio de Janeiro temperature is highest? February. Yes, the answer is exactly correct. Good student. So now you understand how to read. What about others? What about others? Still 82 is there. Okay.
Okay, Bhumi is first, second is Aditya. And third is Pratham.
That is natural vegetation and wildlife. Okay, so before moving towards the lecture, there are some animals, there are some flora and fauna. Okay, means some plants and animals are there. So in this plants and animal, there are different species which you have never seen in your life. Okay, so I want to ask you, did you see this flora, this plant anywhere in our India? Okay, so you see. So what is the name of this plant or this? It is nothing but the Catinga, the Brazilian cactus. It is looking like the cactus of our India, but it is the Brazilian cactus which name was Catinga. The next is, it is looking like a berries. Okay, what it is? No, it is not a coffee. No, it is not a tick. Berries, Brazilian berries. Okay, it is a Brazilian berries. Now it is looking like a tiger, but it is not a tiger. Can you tell me which animal it is? No, it is not a cheetah. Yes, exactly, Pratham. It is leopard. Yes, Samriddhi. So here, it means what we understand, the plants and animals, there are n number of species we have seen in the Brazil. But sometime what happened, for example, cat and tiger, they are from the same variants. They are from the same species, but they are somewhere, just look at the cat and just look at the tiger. They are both looking the same, but they are the different. The both animals are different. So here, we understand that the Brazil and the India having n number of different vegetations and wildlife, n number of flora and number of fauna in Brazil and India. So we will go one by one with each part. So first we will go with the Brazilian vegetation. So when we are talking about Brazilian vegetation, as I told you, Brazil is a part which is located near the equator, and that's why there is the n number of rainfall is happening. N number of the rainfall is so much, and because of that we have found there evergreen forest. Okay, so first, as the rainfall varies due to the physiography, in the various landforms we found there, Brazil is located near the earth, near the equator. Okay, and because Brazil is located near the equator, what we have seen, Brazil is having n number of rainfall. Okay, and throughout the year the rainfall is going on because of, but rainfall is going on only on equatorial region. Only on equatorial region, Brazil has having a rainfall throughout the year. As one move away from the equator, okay? If for example, just I will show you the graph so you understand. Okay? So for example, here there is an equatorial forest. Okay, here there is a tropical forest, but as one move away from the equator, the temperature, the annual rainfall is getting decreased. Just look at this, here the 2000 millimeter annual rainfall is there, but as one move away from the equator, annual rainfall is going decreased to 1500 millimeter. And the temperature is also getting decreased, that is 21 degrees Celsius. And here, when the rainfall is 1500 millimeter, it is called as nothing but deciduous forest. And in which animal, which type of animal we see there? Grassland animal we will found in deciduous forest. One by one, we will go to each part. So let's move first to the evergreen forest. So when we are talking about the evergreen forests are found in especially that area where the rainfall is more. Where the rainfall is more, where we found the forest is totally evergreen. And in region, during the certain season, at the evergreen forest, or we can see at the equatorial region, at the certain season, the rainfall is getting lower. But at the same time, throughout the year, the rainfall is going on. And that's why we have found there n number of grasses, n number of vegetation, different types of species of plants and animals. And Brazil has the largest number of vegetation species in the world. You can find n number of flora, n number of plants, different plants, n number of varieties of animals in the Brazil. Because it is located near the equator, you can also find that different types of vegetation like semi-evergreen vegetation, arid vegetation. Arid means desert, okay? Arid means desert. Arid vegetation, then evergreen vegetation. You also find there some plants like rubber plants, mahogany plants. Okay. Then the plants like orchids. Orchid, as you all know, orchid is the one type of flower which you of the forest. Why it is so? Because yes, Amazon forest and the rainfall is throughout the year. We have found different types of varieties of species over there. Now the next is Indian vegetation. When we're talking about Indian vegetation, India vegetation having different types of the regions, having different types of vegetation, as same as Brazil. But at same area, some area, the rainfall is not going throughout the year. As we are facing or we are having different types of season, as summer seasons are there, then the winter seasons are there, rainy seasons are there, and because of this we having different types of vegetation. And the first, that is, we can see in the maps also, evergreen forest. You can see evergreen forest is located in this part. Okay, can you tell me through color, can you tell me the state's name? Dark green color. So which state, according to you, which state it is? Next, that is deciduous forest. Okay, so where you found deciduous forest, student? Okay, Madhya Pradesh. Central part. Okay, fine. Now the next is thorny bushes. Okay. So where you found thorny shrub or thorny bushes? Yes, it is Gulf of Kutch, Gulf of Khambat, Gujarat. Yes, Rajasthan. No, in Rajasthan. Okay, fine. Now the next and last, okay, Himalayan forest. Himalayan forest, obviously Himalayan forest is located in the north side where the cold desert is there. Where the cold desert is there. Now the last and least, that is coastal forest. So coastal forest is located in a smaller section. It is located in a smaller section of the coastal side. Yes, eastern coast, okay. West and eastern part, okay, fine. Telangana, okay. Of rainfall. In region which having receiving
more than 2000 millimeter of rainfall, and where the abundant proper sunlight is having, this is nothing but the evergreen forest are found. Wherever more than 2000 millimeter of rainfall and abundant sunlights are there, at that time you will get evergreen forest. There you will find, and in evergreen forest you always find that the leaves are broad as compared to deciduous forest. The leaves are totally broad and green. You can also find the hardwood is there, then banyan tree, then coconut tree, then heavy and durable tree like mahogany, rosewood, rubber. So here you found n number of trees in the evergreen forest. And always remember, student, here the evergreen forest, you always found where the more than 2000 millimeter of rainfall are receiving. And not only that, where the abundant sunlight. Okay, in the Brazil also, where the evergreen forest you will found, yes, near the Amazon forest, but where the more than 2000 millimeter of rainfall are found and abundant sunlights are there. It might be come in your... So in evergreen forest, you found the trees like mahogany, rosewood, rubber, and there are various types of creepers are there. As you all know, what is the creepers? Yes. So creepers in India, where the evergreen forest are found, you also found there creepers like pumpkin, watermelon. Okay. And afterward, we also see deciduous forest in our India. And what is deciduous forest? Where the rainfall is between 1000 millimeter to 2000 millimeter. Whenever the rainfall is between 1000 millimeter to 2000 millimeter, the forest, it is called as deciduous forest. And here the trees are shaded their leaves, and so that the water is not lost due to evaporation. So in this area where the deciduous forests are found, there you can find the trees like teak, bamboo, banyan, peepal, especially in the area of the central part of India, we found deciduous forest. And where the rainfall receiving is 1000 millimeter to 2000 millimeter. Afterward, the next is the region where the less than 500 millimeter of rainfall are experiencing. Obviously, the rainfall where the 5000 millimeter, sorry, where the less than 500 millimeter of rainfall are experiencing, the region of that area is dry and arid. Arid and dry both are same, okay? The region of that area is totally dry, and because of that we found the thorny shrubs like cactus. And you also find, students, there mustard seeds, the farming of mustard seeds in that area. Usually not all that portion, but some of the portion, for example, in Rajasthan, the thorny shrub area is there. In some area like Jaisalmer, Ganganagar, the rainfall is totally less. It's less than 500 millimeter. But some of the area which having the rainfall, some of the area which having a little bit rainfall, there mustard seeds farming and wheat farming is going on. Okay, so the leaves of that thorny vegetation, the leaves of that thorny shrub vegetation, you have find it is small in size. And the plants like katechu, akaika, khejri, katha, cactus, aloe vera. Okay? Okay. Now, the next and the last one, that is swampy areas. Swampy areas, estuaries, lagoons, it means the coastal vegetation. Okay, and the coastal vegetation is also called as mangrove or Sundarban in India. Where you can find the saline soil, the salty soil is there and the climate is totally moisty. And that's why the forest is also called as coastal forest, is also called as mangrove or Sundarban in India. And because of the coastal area, you find the wood of this tree is light and durable. It is totally light. So as here we find some forests like evergreen forest, semi-evergreen, or we can say deciduous forest, arid forest, or we can say thorny shrub forest, or coastal vegetation. Now we find about the Himalayan forest. As Himalayan forest having three types of forest. Okay, just look at this.